Hello everyone, good to have your company as we embark on day three of finals here in Rio de Janeiro. World Cup week here in Brazil at the Olympic Shooting Center. It's not there, that is the Olympic Park from 3 years ago, down by the lagoon in Barra. Deodora, well, the lagoons and the beaches all here. We were having a bit of a girl from Ipanema before you joined us. Lots of beaches. Some of the crew down on the Barra Beach early this morning. This, of course, one of the big tourist beaches, Copacabana, Ipanema. Copacabana, where the beach volleyball took place during the Olympics. What a great venue that was. No wonder these are such happy people. Sunshine even in winter. It's a warm one today. And of course, if you're not local, you are a visitor. Lots of sights, including Christ the Redeemer looming over the top of the city. That's the Maracanã. You can see just disappearing out of view on the right-hand side. The football was held. Anyway, we are to the north. This is the Olympic Shooting Centre, and we are ready for just one final after that busy day yesterday. It's the men's 10 metre air pistol. And a bit of a bushfire, as the Australians might call it, outside. Lots of bits of soot flying around, but luckily for these athletes, we're indoors, we're enclosed and in air conditioning for qualification. It's about 59. Athletes will fill out in a minute. My memory is not what it used to be taking part. Only eight, of course, making it to the final. And this is our programme, diminishing by the day. Tomorrow, a couple, but today, just the one, the final of the 10 metre air rifle for men. Of course, the first day we saw the women competing in this discipline. It was a nervy old time. For all these athletes, a lot of time to talk to the coach, a lot of time to talk to yourself as well. That's the target, just 10 metres, I say just 10 metres away. If you stand in the shooting position, look at the target, see how small it is, you realise just how tricky it is to qualify. And, these are the three that have qualified. Two from China, always strong in this discipline. This is obviously what they are wearing, this outfit, very important for stability, to stop swaying and help you get to be a little bit more accurate, and it'll help, of course. Very, very, very strong, these materials, but they can't be too strong, which is why you go through equipment control. Very busy and quite a time-consuming process. You can see the cubes snaking away from the tables. Here are the eight still wearing those uniforms. See the shoes with the stiff platforms. This is what they are shooting with. It is pellets, 4.5mm. Can be quite heavy though, the rifles, 5.5 kilograms. This level be quite expensive as well. You can spend quite a lot of money if you need to upgrade. And, like the athletes, they will be checked for weight and for other technical things to make sure it's all the same. The sights have to be conforming to regulations. It's a very big and thick rule for the IWSF. Don't worry, no danger to the cameraman. They're allowed to dry fire, as they call it. So just practice your routine against a wall. This is just to the right of us. This is where the athletes prepare themselves in very different ways. Some relax, some focused on the last minute adjustments. Well, two quarter places on offer here today. Some have already got there quite a place. Pedagosa in the final, but he's already claimed his at the World Championships in Changwon last year. Marco Subini the same, Munich World Cup. There's a silver for him there. Japan get a bye, so to speak. The United States, the regional events have got their quotas. Russia have also been very strong. Kamensky always a candidate for a medal at the Olympic Games.
Ladies and gentlemen, our great honor here to present our finalists here in this
final of the 10-meter air rifle then. And this is the lineup, A to H, eight athletes.
He took here the seventh place in the Rio 2016 Olympic Games. And also the second
is our first athlete, talked about him just a moment ago. Pedagosa from Croatia, 31 years of age, second ranked in the world. World Cup silver this year in Munich.
Australia
have the green and a little bit of gold of Dane Sampson. And born in Sydney, lives in Brisbane, the world ranked number 14. Best of the World Cup before now was 10th, so he really has stepped up a little bit here. How would he deal with the pressure of the finals hall?
On firing point C, he's representing the People's Republic of China, 20 years
looks
young,
relaxed, the coach.
World ranking number 120.
Shooting position C, next to the Australian, is the Chinese athlete, Yu Hanan, 20 years of age, just 120th in the world. His best was last year in a World Cup in Munich, 14th.
Yu Hanan.
He's already bettered that. Can he be yet another Chinese prodigy? They are producing a lot of them, aren't they?
He's representing Israel, 30 years young, world ranking number.
From Israel, this is Sergei Richter, 30 years of age. He's world ranked just inside the top 30 at 29. Been to two Olympic Games, 14th here in Rio. A World Cup gold 10 years ago in Munich is his best effort. He has three silvers, three bronzes as well. Can he add an extra gold to his roster?
On firing point E, he's representing Slovakia, 20 years young. World
Slovakia have Patrick Jani, 22 years of age. Very inexperienced in finals, just the one World Cup final, 8th in Munich back in 2018.
Let's welcome Jani Patrick.
So Patrick Jani, world rank 30, firing position E.
On F, the athlete is representing.
Next to him, the second Chinese athlete.
22 years
is Song Buhan. 22 years of age, qualified top. World Cup gold 2 years ago in New Delhi. And we'll be looking for another one here.
On firing point G.
Do we have to introduce you
to?
Next one is the 20-year-old Marco Subini of Italy, inside the top 20 in the world at 17. Junior gold in the World Championship mixed team. Junior World Cup bronze at Seoul. Got a gold in three position there in that competition. So looking for his first senior World Cup medal here.
He's representing India, the athlete, 31 years young, world ranking number 11. Second place.
Well, India won gold in the women's competition. Can they win here as well? Deepak Kumar, 31 years of age.
And ladies and
gentlemen,
best
at the World Cup, fourth in Guadalajara. Last year, he'll be hoping to go at least one better. A jury member in charge is Maureen Spinney. She's from Canada. And our chief range officer has had a busy week. He did all three finals yesterday. It's Oscar Martinez of Venezuela. Very happy, cheerful gentleman, always with a smile on his face. Smiles amongst the crowd here.
Take your positions.
Just a reminder of how it works. This is the 10 meter air rifle final for men. Two series of five shots for each athlete, then single shots of 50 seconds allowed for that. And after each two shots, we lose an athlete. Gold after 24 shots. So 14 single shots. So it's important that these athletes get off to a good start. They'll do playing catch up a little later on. Clock is set, not that clock, the clock on the scoring board at 4:10. We're just waiting to be set on our way in this competition. Good shot of the shoes, which gives stability, protection.
For the first competition series,
as well.
Low.
The suits with stability, protection for the back, of course, because that position,
start.
The asymmetric position, not really your natural back position. And they will arch their back just to try and keep some stability. Clock is counting down then, 5 shots for each of these athletes. They'll be looking to be at least in the 10 ring. Kumar not quite there with his first shot. He will try and adjust from that high shot in the nines. Sapini, that's good. Excellent from the Australian Sampson, and Gorser on this left-hand side also shooting well. 10-9, of course, the absolute bullseye. Just half a millimetre. See the targets. Well, they are laser targets, a web of lasers able to give a X and Y coordinate of where that pellet has gone through. There is black paper behind, but if they have to, they can go and do some measuring if there's a problem. Fingers crossed that doesn't happen. Song struggling. Sampson with a 10-9. Goodness me, what great shooting that is. And he dropped 0.2 of a point in those first 2 shots. Looking really good, the man from Brisbane. Remember, his first World Cup final. He's keeping himself nice and calm. This is Gorser of Croatia. Just a reminder of the situation for the Olympic quotas. Australia's Dane Sampson, Slovakia's Patrick Jani, and India's Deepak Kumar can get the Olympic quota places. Still just over 2 minutes of this series to go. Should the athletes need it? Kumar with a 10-8. That's much better from the Indian. He's still down in 8th place, though, so he needs a few more like that. Sampson is shooting brilliantly at the moment. Almost a point ahead of the rest. Another 10-8. He's had a 10-9, a 10-7. Oh, and well, commentator's curse, 9-8. After that, he'll be disappointed with that, but it still means he's top at the moment. And 9 from you, who comes to the party in shooting position. See, no wonder they're smiling in the seats where the Chinese supporters are. Seconds to go, but these athletes are shooting pretty quickly. Song, and they can only shot 3. Plenty of time. Sampson looking to get his last one away. At the other end, you saw Supini, Kumar, of course, as well. Yu wraps up his with a 10.6. Drops him, keeps him at 4th place. Sampson has been overtaken by Gorser momentarily, but that 10.7, I think we'll see him leapfrog back up again. I make it by just 0.1. Well, who is left? Who is left? There's the coach filming and making notes at the same time.
Stop. 8
from Richter. That was worth the wait for him, wasn't it? That's for sure. Sampson has, apart from that 9-8, shot absolutely brilliantly. The man on shooting position B. And despite that, Gorser just 0.1 behind. More consistent, I guess, that 9-8 hurting Sampson a little bit. At the bottom, Sabini and Kumar. Sabini, not that far away from Kumar. Kumar with a bit of work to get close to Yanni.
Smartphone.
Everything's high tech nowadays, isn't it? Who needs a piece of paper? Oh, we do. Just one piece of paper then. Look at that. Signing in. Oh, yeah. Feeling old. There's an app for everything, isn't there? Even if you want to train. Back on the second series of five shots, the last series of five shots. Dane Sampson is the man who is battling it out at the top with Pelagorsu, who shot a 10-8, so that's dropped Sampson down to second. Using the palm grip. Rest the rifle on their knuckles, of course. It's just a matter of personal preference, but he's going really well. 10-6 again, hitting the 10 ring regularly. It's on the 10-7. Kumar better this series at the moment, but Gorsa is really, really consistent. And it's a really good battle between the two on the left-hand side of the screen. Gorsa in the blue and white. Sampson in the colours of Australia. There's Gorsa, 31 years of age. Man from Veer. Already a World Cup silver this year. That got him an Olympic quota place, so he's not fighting for that. He's fighting for the gold medal rather effectively. Officials watching over proceedings, of course, Chief Range Officer. The man who will be starting and stopping proceedings. Kumar struggling to stay with the rest. Him and Supini, 7th and 8th. Grouping better from Kumar at the moment. He is quite some distance ahead of Supini, but it just depends on how many shots have been taken. 10-5 from Supini, keeps the pressure on Kumar. Gorsa and Sampson continue to shoot Brittany. Yu has shot in the tens all this series, and he has the best grouping of them all. So almost done, just a minute left. Couple of shots to go from these athletes. 10-8 from Sampson. Really going well. And that puts him top of the park at the moment, although Gorsa has another shot here. Sampson can just relax a little bit, make sure he's ready for the single shots. Gorsa. That's 10.3.
Stop.
0.3 behind. Hey, Sampson.
After the second series, a great 52.7 from you, that bro.
You may have heard the announcer say 52.7 from you, who shot beautifully through that series. That's hauled him up into third place. Richter there or thereabouts, although 0.9 is a bit of a distance to make up. Supini in all sorts of bother in eighth. Different colours, different styles, all with one objective: to be more accurate than the athlete either side of you. More of a beard plate than a cheek plate for Sampson. There we go. Really helps the athletes replicate the same stance, the same position, the same angle, shot after shot. See some of the athletes with the tape measure out, putting their feet in the right place. This is the battle for first at the moment between Sampson and Gorser. Remember, we're into single shots now. 10 from Gorser, chance for Sampson to extend the lead, and he does, goodness me, 10-7. Excellent shooting. Kumar a 10-4, Supini a 10-7, Song a 10-8, Yanni a 10-7, Richter a 10-4, everyone coming to the party. Nothing less than a 10.4. These athletes really starting to raise the stakes here. Supini is a point behind Deepak Kumar at the moment. He's 1.1 behind Song. That's the battle at the bottom. 0.6 between Sampson and Yu, who's leapt over Pierre Gorser into second place.
For the next competition shot, low.
Feeling the pressure. There he is. 20-year-old from Vergato at the Vergato Club. I'm sure they'll all be watching with interest. Remember, this is the second single shot. We will lose somebody here. So, who's it going to be? These two, or maybe somebody else, have a really off day. Kumar 10-2, Supini 10-3. It's not going to be enough. Keeping an eye on Song, who hasn't shot. He shoots a 10-2, that'll keep him safe. 10-9 from Gorser, by the way.
Stop.
And a 10-4 from Sampson. You shooting a 10-4, so it is Sampson still in the lead. But eighth place goes to the youngster in his first senior World Cup. He takes eighth place.
Let's have a look on the top of the board. In the lead, Samson Dean, so he lost here 0.1, and now Peter Kosa.
Disappointment from the coach, but it is what it is. A little shrug from the youngster.
And on seven
experienced right already now, at 20 years of age, went to Nanjing to the Youth Olympic Games, in fourth at the Junior World Championships last year, so a lot more to come from him. Confirmation then. Supini goes first, and we're about to get underway in our next series. It's now Kumar with a bit of work to do. Sampson just keeping himself ahead of the rest. Supini gone, will Kumar join him? Well, he's doing what he can to stay in. A 10-6 is good. Yu a 10-5. It's Song, keep an eye on Song, and he's matched Kumar with a 10-6, so he's keeping himself in contention.
Stop.
Sampson a 10-2, which means the difference at the top is just 0.1. One more shot, and we will lose our next athlete. Kumar, remember, is one of those athletes who could take an Olympic quota place. Remember, India have been so good so far. Yesterday, in the 10-meter air pistol competition, Abhishek Verma taking the gold. And Vanil Valarivan taking the gold for India in this competition. Women's competition.
For the next competition shot.
They've got a bronze medal as well, so they have had a very successful week so far. But
start.
It looks like Deepak Kumar might have to settle for seventh here. That would leave Dean Sampson and Patrick Yani with the Olympic quota places. Six from Kumar again. He's shooting well. He's left himself a lot to do. And Song Buhan is a cool customer. He's taking his time. 10-9 from you, by the way, whilst we watch this. And it's a 10-4. It's enough to keep him in the competition. And means that Deepak Kumar the world number 11
will
have to make way. Better results, he certainly had better results in the 50 meter rifle three position competition, World Cup silver and bronze. In the World Cup in this discipline, best is fourth. He's not going to improve on that here. Seventh for Deepak Kumar of India, misses out on the Olympic quota place.
And we congratulate here Kumar Deepak of India. Thank you very much for being here. Seventh place.
There you go. It's a long old walk back. There's the man
Ladies
who
and gentlemen,
won gold yesterday, Abhishek Verma. Will be disappointed for his teammate, I am sure.
These two quarter places are decided. Now it goes to Australia and to Slovakia.
Just announced the fact that the quota places will go to Australia and Slovakia. The Australians
for the
Slovakians in the crowd,
shot.
Funnily enough, Lower. Pretty happy with that news. Now then, Dan Sampson will look just to block that
Start.
Out, keep calm, and look to get back onto the top spot, because Yu Huanan with that 10.9, well, he outscored him by 0.9, and Sampson is now second place. Yu will look to keep that improvement going. Two athletes on the right hand side have exited. Six left. Yu again, brilliant. Sampson unable to match him. Gorser is in
Stop.
Third place. Further 0.4 behind Sampson. So, interesting stuff. Song, the other Chinese athlete, is at the bottom and is 0.8 behind Sergei Richter of Israel. So it's a big ask for Song. It's not impossible.
154.9. Next single shot will decide here sixth place.
For the next competition shot, low. Start.
Nothing the coaches can do but watch, take note. See if there's anything they can do to help. Richter, the Israeli on the left-hand side. With that very distinctive routine. Brushing the cheek plate with his beard before getting into position. 10 from Song. Well, it's possible that Richter
Stop.
Could falter, but it's not, and it is Song who has to go.
And we congratulate the People's Republic of
Another
China.
Youngster from China. They certainly are cheering out some great athletes, aren't they? It's Song Buhan, 22 years of age, qualified first. He'll have to make way. His compatriot Yu Huanan, just eye shut, blanking out everything. World Cup gold, New Delhi 2 years ago, could repeat it here. He takes sixth place, Song Buhan of China.
Sergei Richter on this fifth place right now. Two single shots for the fifth place.
For the next competition shot.
Two more shots, and we'll know who takes fifth. At the moment, we certainly know where the quota places are going. We know the three that have dropped out. Richter, though, within striking distance of Patrick Yani. And he overhauled him in the next two shots. Yu and Sampson both 10.4, 1.1 the difference at the top. Richter. Just nibbling away at that advantage that Yani has in fourth place. Just 0.2 now, the advantage.
Still in the lead, there is no change here.
Everyone in the 10. It's Gorser, the worst one at 10. Dead. One more shot then. You think it will be either Richter or Yani. You, Sampson and Gorser. They've had the top three places throughout
Start.
This competition, more or less. How different are these two in their approach? Richter, like a fidgety batsman at the cricket crease. Now he settles down. 0.2 the difference. Oh, and a 9-7 is not going to do it, surely, unless Jani really stumbles here. Now a 10-5. Excellent.
Stop.
10-7 from Samson, 10-4 from Gorsa, and a 10-6 from you whilst we were watching these two. And what a shame for Sergei Richter. He's shot really well here, but he'll be disappointed with that 9-7 under pressure. Well, 10 years ago, World Cup gold. He has to make his way as Yu continues with his eyes closed, concentrating just on what he has to do next to him. So, Richter in fifth place, four left, one will miss out on the medals. Who will it be? Jani not that far away, is he, from Petr Gorsa? It's a very tight old race.
For the next competition shot, low. Start.
Two more shots then, before we know who will have the medals, not necessarily in what order. Samson 1 point behind you after leading for a lot of the early stages. Now, Samson needs to not worry about what you is doing. Oh, 10-6 and a 10-4. Not bad, but it's not good enough. A little look at the monitor. Stop. From the Australian, 31-year-old, knows that he's losing ground. At the other end, Jani and Gorsa, it's even closer, just 0.1.
From Samson, this is 10.6. He was increasing now this lead of 0.2, so you in the lead, 1.2 ahead, and then Samson on the second place, Gorsa on this third position.
Even though they try and keep calm, keep the heart rate down, it's hard not to show your disappointment sometimes. So then it's, well, Gorsa and Jani
who are
in danger of dropping out.
Start.
Gorsa, the veteran at 31 years of age, on the left, the 22-year-old Patrick Jani from Slovakia, already secured an Olympic quota place. Can he secure a medal here as well? Coach is able to have a conversation. These two eyes literally on the prize. Oh, 10-7 from Yu is excellent, and Jani with a 10-9 not only stays in the competition but jumps into second place. Samson with a 9.3 has hurt his chances, and he has drop down into fourth place. Goodness me. Well, we thought he was safe. He was a couple of points away, and a 9-3 from Samson was everyone else. Well, Jani with a 10-9, you with a 10-7, Gorsa with a 10-4, and all of a sudden Samson is out of the medals after leading for a lot of the competition. He'll be very disappointed. Certainly his best in a World Cup. He has an Olympic quota place, but agonisingly for the Australian, he doesn't have a medal. Well, real drama there. Samson dropping out, Jani up into second, and Yu shooting so well is now, in shooting terms, a country mile ahead.
Start.
Three left, three medalists. You would be surprised if Yu doesn't take the gold, but it's much tighter between Gorsa and Jani. Gorsa on his left-hand side, Jani on the right, and a Chinese athlete Yu in the middle of the three. Shooting quite quickly, Gorsa and Yu. Jani takes his time.
Stop.
10-1.
Ladies and gentlemen, after the
0.1 the difference between Gorsa and Jani. Yu increasing his advantage to 2.3, still with those eyes shut. It's interesting, isn't it? Blocking everything out, and yet here's a man with no ear protector, no
for the next competition shot.
No blinder. Just a man who's comfortable in the, his own little zone. So who takes bronze? Who stays to probably take silver? Adeyani Gorsa, MSU struggles. Adeyani with a 0.1 advantage. These two taking their time. Gorsa at 10, Adeyani with a real chance here. Gorsa just watching the monitor. Oh, it's a 9-9 and it's a shoot-off.
There is a time for the lowest ranking
finalist
to be
the Slovakian coach cannot believe it.
The next comma is only for Mr. Gorsa and Mr. Adeyani. Position
with a 10-7, even further ahead now. Oh my word.
For the shoot-off, shot low.
Had an open goal, just a tap in and didn't manage it.
Start.
To use some footballing parlance. Some cricketing terminology earlier, so... why not? Shoot off then. High score wins. A place in the last two. Good from Gorsa. What can Adeyani do? Oh, he can do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, great round here.
It is.
After a dramatic shoot-off. Congratulations to Slovakia, to Patrick Adeyani,
who is able to celebrate.
And the quarter place.
No wonder the coach is happy.
2020.
Well, Patrick Adeyani shot brilliantly to keep himself out of danger earlier on.
And
he had a chance to be in the last two. Couldn't do it, went to shoot off, and again takes the bronze, gets a quota place, so it's pretty good news despite that. Confirmation then, bronze going to Patrick Adeyani. Samson Adeyani with the Tokyo 2020 quota places already. So then two more shots to decide gold and silver, but Yu is 3.1 ahead and he's shooting just breathing.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Yu 10.7, Gorsa 10.2, he's increasing his lead.
3.3 the advantage now.
One shot more to go.
For the next competition shot, low.
So then, one more shot.
Stop.
And I can't envisage any way that Gorsa is going to overcome a 3.3 disadvantage. The world record is also on the line here for Yu. As he shot there, a 10-2. Well, the pressure is certainly off him.
Stop.
And he has got a world record as well. Yu Haonan, absolutely exceptional shooting. Didn't do too much in the first few shots, then all of a sudden, really high tens and a world record for Yu Haonan of China. Just 20 years of age, not only a world record, a world junior record as well. And when you consider his World Cup best was 14th up to now. His first gold medal. Gorsa, well, what can you do when your opponent is shooting like that? He takes the silver, and a very hard-fought silver it was as well. Well, welcome a new superstar, another Chinese athlete who has the world at his feet. Those are the three medalists. Patrick Adeyani with the bronze, Petr Gorsa with the silver, but a world record out by country mile. The gold medal goes to Yu Haonan of China. Well, a gold medal and a world record, and he still looks as cool as a cucumber. How about that? I wish I could be as cool and collected as that young man. I suspect we're going to see a lot more of him in the next few years. Who would count against him if he can produce that kind of form at Tokyo. These are our three medalists. You've got to feel a little bit for Dane Sampson. Our last poor shot, I think it was a 9-3, wasn't it? Dropped him into fourth place, but a quota place, so he has something to celebrate as well. Well, the coach will be happy. Certainly done her job. The coaching team looked quite like a selfie with the world record holder. What an extraordinary final that was. Look, for all the world, like Sampson was going to take the gold for such a long time and then started to falter. And then we noticed you coming through the ranks. And 10-7s, 10-9s. He was disappointed probably with a 10-4. That, if you keep shooting, that is the quality that's going to get your teammates smiling. Not the day for Deepak Kumar, couldn't get that Olympic quota place. Watched by young and old. They fell by the wayside, one by one. Sampson couldn't get onto the podium, but got an Olympic quota place. But this was the man who swept all before him. A massive margin of victory. Yu Hanan takes the gold, and he takes the world record as well.